There are several hotels and hostels in the area, but as we mentioned earlier, most traceurs find themselves staying at the Formula One. It's definitely placed right in the thick of things, just off the highway and within walking distance of both Lisses and Évry. You can book it online by going to Formula One's main website and searching for Évry A6. If you're traveling with friends, you can split the cost so that each of you pays only about a dozen euro a night. The hotel allows you to put up to 3 people in a room for the same price. The rooms themselves are simple, but clean, perfect for traceurs. Don't expect to watch a lot of television unless you speak French, and if you plan to use the internet while you're here, bring a working credit card. There's a good wireless connection, but you pay by the hour. Only 2 warnings for visitors. First, bring your own towel. You'll be glad you did. Second, while the hotel offers a decent breakfast, it might be better to skip paying the extra euro and buy your own elsewhere. Cereal and toast is fine for the average person, but traceurs may need something with a little more energy. Other than that, the hotel is great. Your rooms are unlocked with access codes, so you don't have to worry about losing a key or getting shut out after hours. There are plugs for your cameras and phones as long as you bring an adapter, and the staff are friendly and courteous, provided you don't make a huge mess or bang around in the middle of the night. As for food, you have plenty of options, depending on how much money you're able to spend. There's a pizza place in the hotel parking lot and a steakhouse across the street, not to mention all of the restaurants in Évry. Most traceurs, though, tend to do a little bit of grocery shopping each morning to carry them through the day, either at the Marche Franprix in the center of Lisses, or at Évry 2, the gigantic mall-slash-supercenter in downtown Évry. The Marche Franprix is a little more convenient, but the owners keep odd hours and sometimes decide not to open at all if it rains. While the Carrefour in Évry 2 is a bit of a hike, but a better place to go if you need anything else in addition to food. Also in Évry is the only laundromat that I, at least, was able to locate in my 2 trips to the area. If you're really tight for cash, you always have the option of washing your own clothes and hanging them out to dry. But if you have a few coins, it's quite convenient to throw in a load and then spend the hour training. The laundromat is located right next to one of Évry's most famous hotspots. As for keeping track of your money, yes, debit cards will work in Lisses for most banks, so you don't have to carry everything with you at all times. There's an ATM located right next to the Marche Franprix. You've probably seen it a dozen times in videos without recognizing it. Just around the corner is a phone box, too, so if you don't have a cell phone that will work in France, you can still keep in touch with the folks back home. You can purchase a phone card from the news shop on the Long Riage, right next to the phone booth. For the most part, I think that pretty much covers it. Food, shelter, cash, and communication. I can't tell you much about the nightlife in the area, but since most of us are training hard enough to collapse at the end of the day, I don't think entertainment is much of an issue. Of course, you do get the odd rainy day that makes parkour a little tricky, but if you really can't stand the boredom of the off hours, just try talking to some of the locals. You'll either have a decent conversation, or you'll get a real incentive to learn some French before your next visit.
Oui, en français, hein, je vous parle. Ouais, bon, disons que on voit pas mal de jeunes qui sont un peu de partout en Europe, qui viennent nous voir, et aussi de l'autre côté de la Manche, des États-Unis. Ces jeunes, ce sont des sportifs. En général, les rapports se passent très bien avec ces gens-là. Il n'y a pas de soucis. La seule chose qu'on demande, c'est le respect des populations et des gens dans leur exercice de leur activité sportive sur le lieu même de la copropriété. C'est un sport qui pour moi, je ne pratiquerai pas parce qu'il est pour moi un peu trop violent en termes de choc.
Jean-Luc is a long-time citizen of Lisses, and a part of the community which pays for and maintains the Place de Chevreuse, familiar to many of us since the earliest parkour videos. He has seen many traceurs come and go over the years, and offered to share his thoughts with us one day while we were training.
Every time I speak with these people, oh, it's okay, we can speak, we can exchange ideas. For us, what is not good is the dusty, yeah? The dusty who stay on the walls, les traces. Je ne sais pas traduire en anglais. J'ai pas la traduction qui me vient.
The traces Jean-Luc is speaking of are the marks on the walls of the plaza and other famous locations. Black streaks from our shoes that remain long after we've gotten tired and decided to go home. For us, they're not really a problem. But for Jean-Luc and the others who live here, this is home, and those black streaks are signs of a subtle imbalance in Lisses, as traceurs leave their mark on property that does not belong to them.
Mm. We ask to the people who practice the sport to have the respect of the people and the property of the people. Why? Because we all together paid for all the walls, the painting, and so on. Mm. You know, it's an open place here. Mm. You can practice your sport without problem. In total respect.
Ouais.
Don't practice in the stairs, in the ways. Because when you are in the stairs, in the ways, you are by the people. Mm. You understand what I mean?
Oui.
It is not for you to say, don't go in the stairs.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oui. It's their stairs.
It is not what I say.
Mm-hmm.
It is, I enjoy to meet people and speak with you, for example, with you, this young German. I have no problem with the sportman who come with his friends to practice. We generally have no problem. I understand your sport. I understand. Mm. I have the spirit of the sport, but the sport must be practiced in total respect. Respect the other, mm-hmm. is also respect yourself. Sport with the mind.
Right. Not just the body, but the heart and the mind.
Mind and heart. David and Sébastien have turned a film, mm-hmm. for Nike.
Yeah? Right. Right.
And they ask the property, mm-hmm. to do this thing. All the people, all the representative of the property, mm-hmm. said no.
Mm-hmm.
I said yes, and the other said yes. Because why? I said, if that can give a chance to David, mm-hmm. or Sébastien, for the future of their life, making their sport, or you can say yes, but in the spirit of the respect of our property and our people living in the property.
Jean-Luc is talking about the original Nike advertisements that became Parkour's big break. The other homeowners in Place de Chevreuse were reluctant to give permission for filming at first, but noticed the reason why they gave in the end, out of support for the young men who were practicing parkour. If these advertisements could offer them a chance to do something great in life, the people of Lisses were willing to let them try. One has to wonder now whether they regret that decision. In the spirit of cooperation, they reached out to help a few young traceurs along a path that many of them disagreed with. They did it for the people, for Belle and Foucan and their friends, not for the sport itself. And in return, those original traceurs established a code of respect for the city and its occupants, always training as quietly and unobtrusively as possible, never practicing in ways that would damage the buildings or disrupt the people. Yet now, hundreds of traceurs enter Lisses every year as if it were their own, many of us making no effort to connect with the people or to thank those whose generosity allows us to train. Where is the cooperation, the give and take? Where is the recognition of the debt that we owe to the citizens of Lisses? I am just another traceur. I don't speak with any particular authority, and I can't tell anyone what to do. But throughout the rest of our time together, this is a question that I will raise again and again, because I think it is absolutely central to the idea of the pilgrimage. The goal of parkour is to help people. If we allow ourselves to become a burden and a nuisance in the very town that gave birth to our discipline, what does that say about us as traceurs? Most of us cause no problems during our visit. Most of us are respectful. But I believe we've reached a point where simply being respectful is no longer enough. No one traceur considers himself responsible for the black marks all over Place de Chevreuse, but the fact of the matter is that each and every traceur contributes to them. It's time for us to shift the balance, to become a positive force in this town that is so important to us, rather than simply taking it for granted as if it will always be there to welcome us, no matter how we behave.